Thank you so much, Annie. Oh, I think word's gotten out about this place. But hey, waiting can be fun, right?
Yeah, totally.
I'm sorry, I just thought supplying our respective teams with caffeine fixes is sort of our thing now.
I want to tell my boss we're dating.
Say something.
I'm just, we were on coffee and now we're on talks with bosses.
Well, there's an FBI barbecue coming up and I want you to come with me.
Okay. Yeah, same page now. I think you should totally tell your boss so I can meet your team. This is great.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so then why does it seem like you're worried?
He could take me off as NCIS liaison.
No, he wouldn't do that. Would he?
If he felt like there was a conflict of interest.
Shoot, I have to run to K-Bay. I think you're doing the right thing. It's gonna be okay. Really. Sorry, it's cold.
It's all right, doing your job. Are the leads warm at least?
Nobody I talked to at K-Bay knew where Cobb went the night he was murdered, who he was with, or why he had a weird chemical in his lungs.
Okay, did they have anything else to say about him?
I did learn he was from Daytona, had no non-judicial punishment, and he also brought donuts to work at the motor pool every Monday.
So the leads are colder than the coffee?
Well, except, in spite of a bright future with the Marine Corps, he was getting out.
Any word on where he was going?
Never submitted for travel orders back to the mainland.
Maybe he was staying here.
I mean, it makes sense. Everybody I talked to assumed Cobb had an entire life outside of K-Bay that he just never talked about.
A life that led to his murder. But do we have any ideas on what he might have been mixed up in? Drugs, reckless behavior?
Never popped positive or arrested. He was squeaky clean. But yeah, he had to have been staying for something. Can't just be the palm trees.
Maybe it was for someone.
$100,000 cars with tens of thousands of dollars of modifications. Camshafts, headers, carbon fiber paneling. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
I am hearing a lot of words that I understand individually, but not together.
Okay, what's up?
Nothing. I'm thinking about barbecue and full transparency, and it's freaking me out.
So, Whistler.
Yeah.
I thought everything was smiles and sunshine since you guys got back together.
Yeah, I know. It's been amazing. So amazing that she wants to tell her boss about us.
It's a big deal.
Good. Good, because then it's not weird that I'm freaking out.
That's a big deal for her. Why are you freaking out?
Because she's our FBI liaison. What happens if her boss changes his mind after he finds out about us? And then we no longer work together. And then we start to grow apart. And
if that even happens, you'll roll with it.
Well, it's not just me. She's worried about it, too.
Of course she is. I mean, Whistler might have gone full Adele in front of our entire team, but she wasn't always that person. Just saying.
Hey, we got any more info about the illegal races?
Ask the resident expert.
Wouldn't say I'm an expert.
Well, you do know a lot about cars. You were fanboying over that maneuver Lonnie pulled out of the track.
I don't know. I got into cars and street racing a long time ago.
Ooh, I feel like there's a story.
Well, it started when I watched The Fast and the Furious.
I was wrong.
Wait, I'm sorry. The movie about cars.
First off, it's a movie about family. And are you serious, dude? You haven't watched it? Oh, right. It's not part of the Nora Ephron cinematic universe.
Okay, listen, maybe you two can have a movie night, all right? But for now, how about pointing me to any leads regarding Cobb?
Yeah.
Yeah.